Good evening, everybody. We just did a concert. It was actually supposed to be on Facebook Live and YouTube at the same time. Not sure what happened, but you know, we're getting cabin fever, so I'm clicking buttons, and I guess I didn't click it enough for Facebook. So welcome everybody to the Facebook Live now of the concert that I just did that was supposed to be on Facebook Live and YouTube, but was only on YouTube, but there were lots of people on YouTube. So thank you for being there. And now we're going to do this program again, but on Facebook Live. So hopefully this time I'll play it better. I don't know. Hope you're home. We're all home. This is the third concert actually that I'm doing on Facebook Live for Stay at Home. And did one two Saturdays ago, last Saturday, and now this Saturday. And I've chosen some different pieces to, a little bit different actually. First one is a piece by a friend of mine from Italy, and his name is Giovanni Alevi. I played one of his pieces last week. And this one is called, well, I don't speak Italian too well, so don't hate me for this, La Stanza dei Giochi, The Playroom. It's a lovely piece. After that, I'm going to play a work by David Foster, a wonderful piece he wrote in dedication to his four daughters, the first letter of each of their names, called S-A-J-E. And then a piece I wrote yesterday, actually, and then a bunch of Gershwin pieces you probably never heard before. And they're quite remarkable, from his first piece to one of his last. And then juxtaposing a couple of impromptus, Chopin and Reinhold, that kind of, well, I'll tell you more later. Here is the work by Giovanni Alevi from Italy. If you're watching now, Giovanni, hello, and all his fans. And this is called The Playroom. Thank you. love playing his music. He wrote a beautiful piano concerto a few years ago. It's just, he just makes you happy. And he's been with his family in Italy for the last several weeks, and they're surviving. So here is S-A-J-E by Maltaccio Sage by David Foster. And he wrote this for Sarah Amy Jordan Aaron, S-A-J-E. Thank you. I wrote this yesterday, actually, and I just heard melodies and harmonies in my head, and I don't always get to the piano and get to write music. I arrange music, but something original scares me to do. I've always been that way, and people say, write a concerto. I'm saying, I can't. I just can't. But sometimes I get inspired, and I take the plunge, and I write something. I wrote this piece, and I call it A Waltz for Hope. And this is it. For hope. So let's go back more than 100 years. Let's go to 1916, young George Gershwin. He writes a ragtime, Rialto Ripples, 1916. Thank you. Gershwin, 1916. And then speed about 13 years later, a more developed composer, Gershwin, writes a piece called Impromptu in Two Keys. He has E flat major against D major. It's kind of cool, and here's how it goes. Something together for you, arranged by Alicia Zizzer, who is a wonderful musicologist and delved into the history of Gershwin and his manuscripts and lost preludes. And this piece she put together called Blue Monday, based on the 1922 opera, which flopped. But the music was so well remembered that George was asked to write for the first experiment in modern music, which featured Rhapsody in Blue. And that's just another lecture in itself. But Blue Monday is an interesting piece. It immediately starts with the rhythm, da ba ba bum ba bum. And that is kind of Gershwin's tag rhythm, da ba ba bum ba bum. Or ba 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 bum, just those four notes. He does da 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 da, which is really Good Evening Friends. And he does Good Evening Friends through all his music, even Rhapsody in Blue. And at the end of Blue Monday, you hear it. In the middle of Blue Monday, you hear it. And in the lullaby of 1919, you hear it. Good Evening Friends is the rhythm. And in the lullaby of 1919, it has... And that's the main theme of the lullaby, which he uses in the Blue Monday as one of the love themes. So there's a bunch of little things from both pieces, and of course, one of the great songs he wrote, The Man I Love, which is basically, The Man I Love is Good Evening Friends too. So he uses that there, and it actually shows itself first in Blue Monday. But when he wrote it in 1923, it was The Girl I Love. And he deleted The Girl I Love from several shows like Strike Up the Band, Lady Be Good, Rosalie, and then in 1927 he renames it The Man I Love. So here's Blue Monday. I have a little tip here. So I can't turn the pages and play at the same time. Come on in. Okay. Here is Blue Monday, arranged by Alicia Zizzo. Thank you. just to conclude, a couple of pieces. Very interesting to hear two pieces juxtaposing each other by two different composers, but of a similar nature. It's an impromptu in C sharp minor, one by Chopin, which everybody knows, and one by Hugo Reinhold, which few people know. And it's an interesting combination to hear one after the other. First the Chopin, then the Hugo Reinhold, and then in the same key, they both have fast, rapid sections and a beautiful lyrical inner section. And here they are, back to back.
Thank you. Thank you.
good night and see you next Saturday, hopefully at 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. I'll make sure to click the button. Have a good, safe, and healthy